Another day, another smartphone. And today, a very affordable smartphone, reminiscent of a very expensive one. It's the S8 from Blue Boo, not the Galaxy S8 from Samsung. From Blue Boo, a Chinese company who has a device incredibly similar looking to the Galaxy S8, except this one is about $150. Now let's check the back here. We can see MT6750T processor, which is an octa-core. It's packing Android 7.0, a 5.7-inch screen, 1440 by 720, so don't get too excited yet. 3 gigabytes of RAM, 32 gigabytes of storage, expandable through a micro SD card slot, dual rear camera, 16 megapixel plus 3, and an 8 megapixel camera on the front. A pretty big battery though, 3450. Should we show them the bands? There you go, plenty of GSM and LTE support. You can probably use this on your local network, just pop a SIM in, or two. It is also a dual SIM smartphone, dual nano SIMs, or a nano SIM and a micro SD card. So I've got the blue version here. It does come in a black version. I do have a Galaxy S8 here. Look at how similar those are. Look at that. The chin is a little bit larger. The forehead almost identical. Look at that. That's wild. 150, what? Almost 600. The thing I noticed right away is the heft. It feels like a quality device. This is metal around the edge. Oh, we're booting. We're booting here. It honestly feels like I'm holding an S8. No word of a lie. You see you have the on-screen buttons here, but you can hide them. See that? And then bring them back up if you want more screen. The screen itself doesn't quite wrap around in the same fashion that the S8 screen does. It's like a tiny little bezel within a bezel. USB Type-C, a speaker, real S8, Blue Boo S8. No headphone jack. On the Blue Boo device, there's an adapter in the box. Kind of surprising, but it's not in there. It's 150 though. Power switch is in this location over here. SIM card tray at the top. Volume rocker and no annoying Bixby button, which continues to bother me. You have this kind of metallic look, but it is not metallic. That's plastic. There is a fingerprint scanner and a dual lens, dual camera system, and a dual flash at the top as well. We have a power brick, old school USB. So it's gonna go Type-C to traditional USB on the cable as well. If you wanna get a full on Type-C cable, it's obviously gonna work. Not the biggest deal. A little note there from Sky Lee, the CEO of Blue Boo. Shout out to Sky Lee. What a name. I mean, I wish I had a name like that. Can you imagine? They've included a screen protector. This is kind of odd though. As you can tell, it doesn't occupy the entire screen because of the curvature. It's difficult to get a screen protector that goes over the curves. You're probably not gonna install that for that reason unless you're paranoid. This is the adapter I was talking about. Mini jack on one end, type C on the other. Not ideal. $150. They've included a soft, basic, clear case. You gotta appreciate the thought. SIM tray, as I mentioned, hybrid style tray. Feels a little different. It's a little bit wider. The curves are there on both the front and the back. That's something worth noticing there. The curve is on the back as well as the front. It's a comfy hold. You see, it's on max brightness. I mean, it's not gonna be the best screen ever. I can see the pixels a little bit if I go looking. There's the S8 screen. More contrast, more vivid. You got your quick toggle settings over here. Of course, we wanna test out the camera here. There's video, photo. There's a beauty mode, face cute, and bokeh. Let's just take a stock photo here. There we go. It's pretty quick. It looks to me like it had trouble getting focus there, but maybe it's a focusing distance thing, which it might be. Yeah, it appears that this thing has trouble focusing up close. This is more brightly lit. It did a better job of grabbing that. Oh, there we go. With your images, you're gonna have to be a little bit more deliberate. It's not like instantly bang on. Again, I'm looking at a $150 phone. It guessed my age. It says I'm male 28. Can you see this? I'll take that. What, you, 49? I'm aging rapidly here. I'm all washed out. I mean, as it is, I'm already deathly white. Like, this is not helpful for me. Not the sharpest selfie we've ever taken. Not exactly the strong point, but I feel like I'm repeating myself a lot and I kind of have to. $150. Is that what gets you going? Oh. Is that what you always wanted? It's cute mode. Just what I needed. There's also this button here. so you can put filters. So in video mode, you have 1080p, 720p, and 480p on the rear camera, and the front camera maxes out at 480p. Sometimes when I'm looking at inexpensive phones, the speaker is a little bit tinny, crunchy. This is the video you should be watching. Leave this video right now and go watch this one. I mean, I've done over 1,000 videos, maybe 1,500 videos. I never made noises like I made in this video. I never had an experience like I had in this video. I mean, this thing was transcendental.
Ooh. Since I saw the very
pretty quiet.
And I stared up at the universe, well, or the ceiling of the mall, but I'm sore, all right?
That's full blast. Pretty quiet for comparison. S8 sound, not the loudest phone.
Go look at this. This box.
It's now, deeper.
To you,
it's louder.
It's just a wooden crate, but to me, it's a whole new experience. Inside that box is a massage chair.
Okay, so the speaker's not that great. I mean, there's a theme here, okay? Everything is like part of the way there. The software, it's part of the way there. The camera, it's part of the way there. The fingerprint sensor, it's a little bit slower than usual. What's the takeaway? I think for me, it's that it's pretty amazing now what you can get for $150. The fact that it's comparable to a flagship at all, at that price point, brand new, is some kind of achievement. You can get by with this thing. You could get by. I could survive. I could live. This smartphone marketplace is ever expanding to meet the needs of all kinds of different customers, including those who only have $150 to spend on a smartphone. I think it's important to bring some light to these types of devices to show you guys, even if you're not necessarily in this market, and the fact that things are getting a lot better at those lower price tags. First question here from Jerome Miller Jr. Do you see yourself going back to the iPhone? Well, here's the thing. One of the benefits of having a technology-based channel here on YouTube is that I get to try out all the different devices because I get to make content about them for you guys. And I think, to a certain extent, it's a responsibility of mine to put a certain number of hours and minutes into the high profile devices so I can give you guys accurate feedback of my experiences. So when the new iPhone drops, yes, I will be using it for the purpose of that feedback. Now, whether or not I stay with it beyond that really depends on how I feel about it. So that's impossible to answer right now, but I would be surprised if it takes over my daily driver spot long term. Here's one from I Take the Wheel. What is the worst product you have ever reviewed? One comes to mind that happened recently, this little mini Android phone. The thing hardly worked, bit of a disaster. It happens sometimes. Here's one from Ramel Legaspi. What was the craziest phone case you've ever unboxed on your channel? It's either the one that had all these multi-tools built into it, including a knife, and then more recently, one that had a lighter built into it. It's not something I ever thought I would see on a case, but you can never underestimate the case manufacturers. All right, so there you have it. Thanks to everyone who left a question down below. If you want to participate, make sure to leave your questions in the comments of this video, and you might make it into the next episode.